In this video, we will talk about arrays of reference variables. In the last video, we saw an example of an array that holds primitive variables. We learned that the array is itself an object that is accessed using a reference variable. Arrays can also hold reference variables. For example, a bookshelf holds books. Book is an object and bookshelf is similar to an array. We can create an array of books like this. Here, bookshelf is a reference variable of type bookArray since it points to a book array. And there is an array that contains 5 elements of type book. But there is a slight difference with the way a bookshelf holds books. Here the elements of the array do not actually contain a book object. The book object is created somewhere in memory and there will be a reference variable to access it. The array will actually hold the reference variables to the book objects. So we have an array of book reference variables. To achieve all this, we will need to create book objects and assign them to array elements. Lastly, to check the length of an array, we use expression bookshelf.length. This will return a value of 5. So the benefits of using arrays are that they are a quick, ordered, and efficient list of things, and they provide fast random access by letting us use an index position to get to any element. But arrays suffer from a limitation. Their length is fixed and cannot be changed dynamically. Let's recap now. In this video, we saw that arrays can also contain as elements references to other objects like book objects. In this case, the book object needs to be created by using the new operator and then assigned to an element in the array. We also learned the benefits and limitations of using arrays.